Welcome back, guys, and in this movie we are going to discuss about SQLite DB. So we all know that the SQLite DB is the lighter version of MySQL database. So this SQLite comes along with the Python package itself. So if you wanted to implement, you need to import the SQLite package. In my machine I have a SQLite 3, so I'm going to import that. Okay, so accept that import SQLite 3, other are the default template which we have used till in this course. So I'm going to remove the specific line for this tutorial purpose. When we send one request to the root path, then I will be creating one database. SQLite3.connect your database name. So whatever it may be the database name, in my case I'm going to tell students.db. DB is nothing but the extension. The database name is students. Okay, within the DB will be having all the details which we are inserting into it. Let's discuss that in a minute. This will this specific line will create one database within our solution, and also will be returning the connection. This is the variable which actually hold the connection of the student database. Once this line is get executed, we have got our database. So within this database we cannot directly store the data. For that we need to have the tables. Now it's time to create table. So how can I create table? We need to create a table only using the existing connection. Our existing connection presents in the CONN variable. Now you are going to execute your query which is going to create one table. Okay, so for that I'm going to use the execute create table. Table name would be student. So within this student table, for this tutorial purpose only, so that I'm going to have only one column which represents the name. This name will gonna contain data of type text. In case of MySQL, we will be mentioning variable text with the varchar, but in case of SQLite, we need to mention it with the text. Now once this line get executed, we'll be having created, we will be getting one table here. Return render template. If you haven't written any specific method here, it will share some error message. So to make it more precise, I will be redirecting all the message to the content HTML page which I created along with this SQLite.py file. Render template. We all know that how render template is working. This render template is actually comes from the package, Flask package. So render template, I will be telling that content.html is the file where you need to go. Along with this, I'm going to send one message also. This MSG is nothing but the variable which actually acts as a bridge between my Python API and the content.html. I need to use the same variable in the HTML file also to make it work. So here I will be telling DB and table created. So let's move to content.html. Within this body section, I will be using this syntax. This syntax is nothing but the syntax of Jinja template, which we'll be discussing later. So I will be just giving MSG, the same variable name. Okay, now everything has been returned. Now it's time to start the server. So Python SQLite.py. We haven't started that app.run yet, so that is why we haven't got anything. So we need to use app.run. If you haven't used app.run in your script file, this basic file will not run. Now you could see that the application has started and hosted on the port 5000 in my localhost. Let's move to my Mozilla Firefox. So within Mozilla Firefox, I'm going to serve and request to the root path and hit enter. You could see that the DB and the table created. To make it more clear, you could also see here you will be able to see one file called students.db, which is the same name and extension which we given here. This is how you need to create a table and databases in the SQLite DB. You can, since this is for tutorial purpose, I have created database and the table using this route, but in case of the real world application, we will not be creating anything with the user interaction. This will be automatically created based on our scripts alone. If it in case the student database file is already present, then the new file will not be created. It will be using the existing file alone. Let's create another route. Within this route, I'm going to insert new record. For that, I'm mention this as a insert. So insert create record method name def create record. We know that we have already created the database. To use the existing created database, we need to use the keyword called with the SQLite dot connect to the existing database, which is students dot db. This with doesn't return anything, so we need to use the alias name to create one variable. This is called as con. So within this con, I'm going to execute some query to insert into the databases. So conn dot execute. Here you need to tell that insert into student, we have only one column, that name needs to be referred here, values. Here we can tell that the question mark. So the question mark is nothing but the placeholder which actually been replaced with the value. We are passing it here. In my case, I'm going to pass my name for the example purposes. The change is dynamically in a few minutes. Now we have created one SQLite3.connect. Here I have done one mistake. For creating database, creating table only, we need to use the connection object directly. For all other things, we need to use the existing cursor. Cursor will be holding within this cursor. So this cursor object only we need to use to execute all the insert update query statements. Since this is the lighter version, we need to save our changes manually. I have modified all the necessary needed and I'm going to restart my server. The server is having some problem. Since this is the statement, we need to use the semicolon. Now the server has started. Insert. I'm going to my browser to serve and request. This is what we have seen previously. So insert. Press enter. So there is some problem with our code. We need to get back to the Visual Studio Code to rectify the issue. Return at the last with the record inserted statement. This issue record inserted. The problem here is they have used braces. Instead of that, we need to use the curly braces. For SQLite execute query, whenever there is an insert statement, it actually take care of the two argument to the execute method. One is the actual query, another one is the array of input. Okay, so here we need to use the array. In case of Python, we need to tell that this as a list. So I have passed this num. Let's discuss Python SQLite, SQLite.py. The server has started. Let's move back to the cursor. Localhost 5000 slash insert. Insert. You could see that the insert has successfully done. Now it's time to retrieve the data. Let's make the existing URL as a dynamic one. Okay, what I'm going to do is nothing but I'm just going to copy paste the existing one. Instead of this, I'm going to tell this as a dynamic insert. Dynamic create record, dynamic record. Instead of my name, I will be getting value from the text. I will be using the same variable name here as well. That's how it will work. Otherwise, it will throw error. I will be using the same statements. So let's save that. Restart the server. Server has started successfully. Now I will be moving back to my browser to serve the request. Here I need to use the dynamic instead of insert. Dynamic colon instead of value here I need to pass the value here. I'm going to pass value as Arun. So let's enter and wait. The record has been inserted. So both the route is being work. Now it's time to select the data present within our database. So let's create another route which actually act as a app.route which actually act as a select statement slash select. So whatever it may be the value present within the database, I will be selecting all the record, like select star from table name. Def dynamic record here, select all records. Now we need to use the same thing with the SQLite3.connect. So connecting the students database, stu dents dot db file I'm going to create an alias for this, which is called as con. So within this, using this specific connection, I will be going to select all the record. To as I previously said, if you wanted to do any select or something, we need to create one cursor. So for that, cursor equal to con dot cursor. Now we need to use the con dot row factory equal to SQLite 3 dot row, because we are going to access everything as a row. That is why we have mentioned it here. As like previously, we will be using cur dot execute. Here only we will be telling the select query. So select star from whatever it may be the value or whatever it may be the column. I need to get everything from the student table. This is the table which we have created in the previously. So this will be providing you with some value. So rows equal to some data. So we need to use the cursor dot fetch all method to fetch all the record. So all the cursor related data will be present within this. So we need to use the fetch all method to fetch all the record. So let's copy paste this here. That's how it will work. So rows are having all the record present within the server. Now I will be using the same line here to represent it. Example would be, I'm content.html with the messages. So instead of messages, I will be using rows with all the record present within here. So to make it unique, I'll be using rows content. That's all. So I'll be copy pasting this variable here. So we'll remove this. We need to use a for each. Here within this body section only we are going to write our Jinja template to render all the variables. I mean all the record present within the rows content variable. Let's paste the row content here. This is our variable. Within this we are going to use, if you are using two curly braces, that means that you are going to append some variable here. Like means if you wanted to append some data, then you can use the two curly braces. If you wanted to do some condition or something statement or like that, then you need to use the single curly braces with this percentage. In our case, we are going to use a for. This is a variable, so you can use any name here. In this is our variable which actually hold all the content. So from this collection content, I'm going to loop through all the available record. If we start any for if, then you need, that's your responsibility to close it. Here you can use end for to close it. So within this you can literally access all the available one. I mean using the variable row, I can access the column of the table using the columns name. We have created only one column. The column name is name. I'm going to copy paste the same name here also. Now our Jinja template is ready to print all the data present within the table. So restart everything, Control C, restart my server. I'm moving back to the browser to send on request. So instead of dynamic and a name, I will be going to give a select. So select, it will actually hint on the server. Let's see what the error is. Actually, there is a problem in the Jinja template. Here you could see the error message. So it actually asking for end for or else. Actually, I have given end for. Here I have given end for, but even though it is asking for some problem, that is due to this one. That's because I explained it previously. Like if you wanted to print something, you need to have to use the double curly braces. So I have missed it and used it there. Curly braces which is used for the conditions. So I am restarted my server again, going back to browser and refresh the same request. The problem here is like this needs to be come after the, I mean the problem he previously my code was like this. Okay, this is how that is why the connection couldn't able to read all the data. We need to keep this line here. So I have modified that and restarted. Now I could able to check all these are working fine. Okay, these are all the record which we have already inserted. Let's check with another record. So insert slash sorry, dynamic slash name would be Kumar. Enter. Now we need to move to the select to check. Here you could see that the value we have sent is been added here. When you are using dynamic URL, the result we having to got, that is because we have modified the content in the content.html file to this. That is why we haven't get the record inserted successfully message. That's all for this video. Let's meet you in another one.